Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied what is Kohlrausch law and how it is much more influential to calculate the molar conductivity of a weak electrolyte at infinite dilution. So based on that only, we are going to solve a numerical. So let us see. So there is a question which is on your screen, which is based on the Kohlrausch law at infinite dilution for weak electrolyte. It says that the molar conductivity is at zero concentration. In this case, the zero concentration means the infinite dilution of NH4Cl, NaOH and NaCl are respectively given to us. So what would be the molar conductivity of NH4OH at zero concentration? So before understanding it, that what is and how can we derive the value, or how can we find the value of the given requirement, the first thing that we have to do is we have to extract the given data. So before extracting, let us see that these values are being arranged in sequence or not, so that we could manage it in very well direction. That NH4Cl has a value of 149.7, while that of NaOH has a value of 248.1 and that of NaCl has a value of 126.5. So therefore, the given data says that the molar conductivity at infinite dilution for NH4Cl, that is lambda naught for NH4Cl, is given as 149.7 ohm inverse centimeter square mole inverse, while that of lambda naught for NaOH is given as 248.1 ohm inverse centimeter square mole inverse, and while that of for NaCl, lambda naught of NaCl is given as 126.5 ohm inverse centimeter square mole inverse. And the thing that we have to find out is molar conductivity of NH4OH. So let me make it a correction that this all lambdas are capital lambdas, because this all are molar conductivities that they have given to us, and we have to calculate the molar conductivity of NH4OH. So how can we calculate it? So first of all, we have to know that which electrolyte should be eliminated and by which we could get the NH4OH. So in this case, if I would see that NH4OH is present in the electrolyte NH4Cl, while the OH is present on, or OH is present in the electrolyte, that is NaOH. This means that we have to add these two electrolytes and we have to subtract this electrolyte, that is NaCl. So let us see whether we are moving in a right direction or not. So what we are going to do is, according to Kohlrausch law, if we have to calculate the lambda naught for NH4OH, what we have to do is we have to add up the lambda naught for NH4Cl plus we have to add lambda naught for NaOH and we have to subtract the lambda naught for NaCl. So if I equate this thing, or if I separate it in an anionic form and in a cationic form of molar conductivity, I could get lambda naught of NH4 plus lambda naught of Cl minus. Again, for this thing, what I can do is lambda naught of Na plus lambda naught of OH minus. While for this thing, I could write it as lambda naught of Na plus minus lambda naught of Cl minus. So from this thing, what I have got to know is that this Na plus, which is positive, And now this Na plus, now in this case the value which has been negative, they will both cancel out each other, but this and this will cancel out each other. So the thing that is left with me is NH4 plus and for OH minus. So this shows a clear indication that we have to add this two molar conductivities while we have to subtract this molar conductivity. So therefore what I could write is the molar conductivity of NH4Cl, which was found to be 149.7, and that of NaOH, if I add it, then I could get 248.1, and I have to subtract this NaCl, so I could get 126.5. So by doing all this equation, what I could get is 271.3 is the answer that we have got for lambda naught for NH4OH. But the unit is very necessary to be mentioned, so I could write it in this way: ohm inverse, centimeter square, mole inverse. So this is how we have calculated the molar conductivity of a weak electrolyte. And in this case, NH4OH was the weak electrolyte, and hence because of the help of Kohlrausch law, we have estimated this value. It was very much simple. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video, and please share this video with your friends and make them aware of how to calculate the molar conductivity of a particular weak electrolyte present in a solution with the help of Kohlrausch law. So share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.